Anurag has been a lucky charm for me. My first book, Lights, Camera, Masala, Making Movies in Mumbai, featured Anurag prominently. And I was thinking desperately of some connection of between Anurag and Rajnikant. So since I couldn't find any, I thought, let me look at Anurag not as a filmmaker, but as a human being who's a fan of Rajnikant, and asked him to recount his early experiences of Rajnikant, which is there in the book.
They're trying to do everything that, you know, they're trying to capture that aura of his that he had inborn. He had kind of inculcated. Everybody's trying to just copy it and borrow it and, you know, without probably really getting to the root of it. But yes, all the success, because I feel that the Rajnikant movies are a homegrown blockbuster format. Because for years we were trying to do things which were not us. If you call the Indian mainstream blockbuster, masala, summer movie.
The first thing, I cast about many approaches on, you know, how to write this book. Then I realized that the best way, the simplest way forward was to write a chronological narrative. Because otherwise the entire growth journey of somebody from rags to riches, from a humble coolie to the biggest superstar of the country.
The humblest superstar.
And the humblest superstar of the country. I couldn't have traced that journey.